Hi everybody, and welcome to another episode of Feature Friday. Essentially what we're going to try to nail down here in this video is kind of helping you guys figure out how to choose the right lens color, or how we sometimes refer to it as lens type, for your application. Now there's multiple factors that influence the color that may work for you. Some of those factors involve the exposure to visible light, what type of lighting that you're working in, be it natural, incandescent, fluorescent. Those kind of all have that impact when you have those kind of overhead lighting conditions. Exposure to UV is another thing to consider, of course. What kind of visibility and, you know, weather conditions that you're working in. What are your needs in terms of field of view, in terms of, you know, visible contrasting that you may be needing or requiring. And of course, importance of being able to distinguish color within the application at hand, and so whether or not you want to have any kind of light filtration at all. So clear lens is essentially your most basic type that you'll find in any kind of safety eyewear. Of course, this is good for primarily indoor use is what we would say. And essentially, when you have no need for any kind of light filtration or additional kind of protection or enhancement of contrast, clear is essentially the way to go, and typically the most affordable option that you will find in the market. So that's basically your first and foremost. When we go into the gray and the smoke, this is again a very foundational piece here. It helps to minimize the fatigue from the glare. So now, you know, we're talking snow, reflection off the water, things like that, helps, you know, block out the sun rays, of course. It's your standard kind of shaded eyewear. And this is essentially the most popular tint that you're gonna find for any kind of outdoor general purpose applications. So next we're gonna get into amber. So when you get into glasses like this, this is kind of where things get a little bit more interesting, because you get more people kind of being a little interested, like why would you ever really need this sort of like neon yellow vision? Well, the thing is amber lenses actually have a lot of utility. And so these are some of the best for low light kind of indoor applications where you really wanna kind of enhance the contrast in kind of coloration and dark to light. And so, you know, it helps to contrast that kind of the hazy lighting, which can sometimes kind of cause some of the blowout effects on the visuals. It does help filter out blue lighting. And then of course, generally speaking, the ease of the strain on the eyes, like we were saying, and helping to kind of give you that kind of better overall view. The yellow tinting is very popular, generally speaking, with drivers, just because of the enhanced contrast. But there are other colors available for that as well that we're gonna mention later on. So now in combination, when we're talking about the clear, when we're talking about the smoke, we're gonna mention kind of one of the other interesting offerings that's in the market, and that is going to be your indoor-outdoor lens. So indoor-outdoor lenses are essentially kind of that happy middle ground. So they work in both conditions. So they're lightly tinted, as you can see, and especially when you compare them right to the clear. So in indoor conditions, you know, you do get a certain amount of light. Obviously that goes through, which is not an issue. Everything's fine there. But then when you do step outside, you do have a little bit of that protection. So it's always kind of an appreciated kind of middle ground, and it is a popular type for people who are kind of constantly going inside outside rather than having to switch their eyewear in between the two kind of job conditions. Other options you may find available, you know, in terms of your indoor outdoor, if that's what you're in the market for, is going to be your photochromic lenses. So your photochromic lenses are gonna be what people often refer to as transition lenses. So when you're inside, they're gonna be relatively clear, but then essentially when you step outside, they are UV activated, and essentially as the light hits it, they're gonna start kind of transforming into that darker tint where they're gonna look closer to something like this. And then of course, when you revert back to the different lighting outside the UV exposures, they eventually transition back. So next we're gonna get into some of the mirrored finished glasses. So first and foremost, we're gonna be looking at the silver mirrored. As you can see, in comparison with the indoor outdoor, which this one even in itself, just because of the way that that shading goes on, has a little bit of a mirrored finish on its own. But your true silver mirrored lens is gonna be something that's good for general use. But essentially the main key thing with a silver finish or a mirrored finish is that it's gonna basically help reflect the light and reduce the amount of light that really passes through in those additional kind of glare points. So that's really what's good for it. Just because it doesn't have any kind of color hueing to it, it does really help maintain that color recognition. So, you know, good for people that are, again, drivers, different utility workers, line workers, and things like that. But again, more on the outdoor kind of thing, because it does have that heavier tinting. So it's, you know, not the best necessarily for any kind of indoor application. And just generally speaking, good for protection against your glare points. Now, again, sticking with the topic of the mirrored lenses, we have here your blue mirrored lens. Now, blue lenses in general are kind of a different beast, and they are interesting because they really do enhance the contour around objects, and it does help with some of the different kind of color perceptions that you will have when you're outside, inside, but again, primarily because it has a tinting to it, it is generally recommended more for the outdoor use and more commonly used that way. Now, it is helpful for reducing the glare, of course, just because you do have the mirrored kind of finish on here, but it is good in kind of the misty, foggy, snowy conditions. It kind of, again, helps just generally with, you know, enhancing contour and the visualization, you know, helping with the light refractions and things like that. So very common lens for those kind of applications. Now, of course, similar vein to the amber is going to be your copper, or sometimes coined as espresso lenses. So these are basically good for everyday use, you know, everyday kind of UV exposures and things like that, or, you know, these are kind of really good for. But what's really nice about these ones is you're gonna find that there's the enhanced color contrast, particularly good when people are, again, driving out and around, because the common traffic colors, especially red, is actually the main color that really gets stood out by these. But your green, yellow, red in general are gonna stand out a lot more. And so it is perfect for kind of vehicle operations and things like that. So very common lens. And it does really give everything that kind of that sunny sun-kissed kind of look to it. So it is popular just alone for that sake. And then another lens that we didn't really necessarily touch on, but it is in a similar vein as your amber and your copper lenses, is gonna be your red lens. The red is essentially similar benefits. You know, it's gonna be helping your eyes adjust to the contrast and enhance the visual depth. And, you know, generally speaking, they're actually some of the better ones known for, you know, helping your eye strain with the fluorescent lights and the blue lighting. And of course, the mirrored finish being good to help against the glare. Now, last but not least, we're gonna be talking about a green shade, but this is actually your protective shade 5 in this particular instance. Now, when it comes to the green, it is good essentially in this case for the protection against your arc and eye and infrared lighting. So it's, you know, this particular piece here is not necessarily to be used for, you know, direct welding or anything like that. But this essentially provides that protection when you're nearby any kind of flashing IR exposures, you know, welding, cutting applications. This is to protect your eyes from those really bright, quick flashes. And so there's, you know, three different kind of main tiers. We primarily carry the shade 5 here at MacMor, but essentially the visible light transmission at a shade 2 level is where you get about 20 to 28%, shade 3, 10 to 14%, and then the shade 5s here is a 2 to 4%. So that's the video, guys. We hope that you found this really informational. We hope you guys like the content. If you did like it, please consider liking and subscribing. It does give us a hand with our channel, and we do appreciate the support. And yeah, if you have any questions, feel free to hit us up. If you're looking for any kind of particular eyewear that has, you know, a specific lens or tinting or anything like that, just, you know, let us know, and we'll be happy to kind of, you know, help you find the right fit. Appreciate it, guys. Have a good weekend. Take care.